Welcome back. New episodes, new locations, still your same favorite host, Nicole Bonk, head of Skydio flight testing, and this is Flight School. In this episode, we'll be heading out into the field to show you how to use your Skydio drone to get the job done, and the tips and tricks you can use along the way. Today's topic, bridge inspection. Spoiler alert, I'm not actually an expert at inspecting bridges, but fortunately, I know someone who is. So let's go into the field with bridge inspection expert, Dave Berman, one of our solutions engineers here at Skydio. He's going to be showing us the different ways you can use your Skydio drone for bridge inspection. Dave, what are we inspecting today?
We are here in Auburn, California at the Forest Hill Bridge. And as you can see behind me, this one is an absolute beast.
2,400 feet long, 730 feet tall, 4 lanes wide, concrete support pillars and structural steel truss. This bridge has it all.
This is a prime example of where Skydio technology can be utilized to help you complete your bridge inspection quickly and safely. Let's get started.
There are 3 main ways you can use your Skydio drone to conduct a bridge inspection: manual inspection with Skydio Autonomy, 3D capture, and 2D capture. Manual inspection is where you manually fly your drone to a specific area of interest. You may do this to investigate a crack, or you may be getting a closer look to see if you need to deploy a hands-on crew to survey the problem. Here, we are looking at any potential rusting on these bolts or any abnormal wear. Let's also take a look inside the truss. With Skydio Autonomy features like obstacle avoidance and visual navigation, your drone can fly safely in GPS-denied environments and close to obstacles, so you don't need to be an expert pilot to perform a bridge inspection. Maneuvering in this area would be nearly impossible using traditional methods like a snooper truck. Another way you can use your drone for bridge inspection is Skydio 3D capture, which is available with a 3D scan license. This mode automates the capture and inspection process for large, complex structures like bridges. With very little input from the operator, your drone will create autonomous flight paths to capture your structure from all angles. Simply set up a volume where you want the drone to operate in, adjust your settings, and your scan will automatically capture all the photos you will need. This data can be reviewed on site, backed up to Skydio Cloud, or used to generate digital twins with photogrammetry software. Skydio 2D capture is similar to 3D capture, but here you will capture large surfaces instead of complex 3D structures. This is perfect for roadways or bridge surfaces. It also has an upward capture capability, which allows you to fly traditional mapping patterns, but with the camera pointed 90 degrees up. This lets you look at typically hard to capture places, like underneath bridges.
Thanks to Skydio Autonomy, all of these different missions can be performed with little to no training. And most bridge inspections that use drones experience drastically reduced inspection times and end up with much more usable data.
Dave, before you jump to the next section, I love cheesy action movies. Isn't that the bridge from the movie XXX?
Sure is, Nicole. You can still find pieces of that old Corvette down by the water. And that's a perfect segue, because we want to talk about the hazards and challenging environments when conducting a bridge inspection and how your Skydio can help.
From unpredictable winds to dense obstacle environments, we know that bridge inspections can often present challenging hazards. Here are a few of the Skydio Autonomy features that will help you safely fly and accomplish your mission. Obstacle avoidance is always working, whether you are flying manually or flying autonomously in 3D scan. If you need to reduce obstacle avoidance, you can do this in manual mode, allowing you to get into those hard-to-reach places. Perform finer, more controlled manual inspections with stop at structure. By default, as Skydio approaches obstacles, it will veer away. With stoppage structure toggled on, it will not deviate from its course when approaching a structure. Instead, the drone will reduce speed and maintain position, allowing for more precise maneuvering and more controlled inspections.
Oftentimes, when flying near bridges, we'll want to enable strict boundaries so that your drone doesn't fly into traffic or other hazards and it stays within the planned flight area. If flying manually, you can set your flight limits in the drone settings. If you're flying 3D scan, you can set a strict visual geofence in 3D space. For your ceiling, floor, lateral boundaries, your drone will stay in this area.
Skydio can operate near these large metal structures without electromagnetic interference. Unlike other drones, Skydio uses visual navigation so it can fly in GPS-denied environments or environments with EMI. Wind warning is another great feature when performing a bridge inspection. Your Skydio will warn you if the wind is too strong to fly and will prompt you to return home.
All of these features will help you fly safe and confidently when performing a bridge inspection. We know that our inspectors already have full-time jobs being inspectors, so we make the flying process as intuitive and easy as possible.
Good luck finding those Corvette pieces, Dave. So we just learned about the different ways you can use your Skydio drone to perform a bridge inspection, plus the Skydio autonomy features that will basically act as your co-pilot as you fly. If you want to get formally trained before your mission, Skydio offers live, in-person training, as well as online courses where you can become a Skydio certified operator in no time. Learn more at skydio.com or reach out to us to get your account set up. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time right here on Skydio Flight School. I'm not actually an expert at inspecting a bridge. Today's topic, bridge inspection. How was that energy level? That was the 10 that we needed? Okay. Dave, what the hell were we doing today? Should I take it down a notch? And here I thought it was only old ladies who played bridge. That's so great. And we'll see you next time right here on Skydio Flight School.
Not
tap on the table. I knew you were gonna say that.
That's a link to.
Really? I don't think this is working.